Hey, it's Mikey, and welcome to another easy gold camo guide on your road to gold, diamond, and DM Ultra, this time for the SMGs. And even though this guide does feature the MP5, a lot of the same type of classes, playstyle, this can all work with all the different SMGs, mix and match what you need. And also, I've already covered some of the challenges in separate videos, so I will have timestamps if you need to skip ahead. And remember, if you enjoyed these videos, please be sure to no-scope that like button. With that out of the way, let's get started with ranking up. So as we know, weapon rank is mostly tied to time played. And at the time of this recording, you need a lot of time played, over 8 hours to reach level 50. That's a big deal because challenges are locked behind rank. So this makes getting camos a grind. For that reason, I played a few hours of zombies and I reached weapon level 30 before even setting foot in multiplayer. Remember, weapon rank carries across all modes. So even though I played until rank 30, I'm not saying that you have to. That's just what happened in my case. I am just mentioning it since it can make the grind a little more interesting, a little more chill. And another benefit to reaching a higher rank in zombies is once you go back to multiplayer, you can work on multiple challenges at the same time. And that is what I did. I ended up working on 4 camo challenges at once. So we had spray, get 300 eliminations with the MP5 in multiplayer. Then we have stripes, which is get 75 headshot medals with the MP5 in multiplayer. Classic, get 5 kills without dying 20 times, all kills coming from the MP5 and multiplayer. And Flora, kill 75 enemies detected, stunned or blind by your score streaks, equipment, or field upgrades and multiplayer. And you notice I did skip geometric, that is, get 50 long shot medals with the MP5 and multiplayer. So long shots, not the best in free-for-all. We're gonna focus on that later. And that is the mode for our first 4 challenges. You can play core or hardcore. Remember, in hardcore, it is 1 bullet to the head. The downside is you die 1 bullet. So there is a trade-off. Just pick the one that matches your playstyle. And I tend to like hardcore free-for-all. It's great. And it can be relatively slow-paced, making it easy for headshots. It's great for equipment, UAV kills, all kinds of stuff. So like I said, in my case, I did choose hardcore free-for-all, 1 shot to the head, but normal free-for-all can work too. The main challenge I focused on out of the 4 was Flora. Kill 75 enemies, stunned or blinded by your score streaks, equipment, or field upgrades, and multiplayer. And this is the class I built around that, but it's also great for headshots. And the other 2 challenges, stripes and spray, those will just come on their own passively. Just make sure that every kill you get, you're always aiming for the head. So let's get into my free-for-all class. So first things first, for every single challenge from here on out, doesn't matter what weapon it is, it's always spy plane, counter spy plane, and that is pretty much it 99% of the time. The goal is to complete camo challenges, and running anything else will simply distract you. And not to mention, the challenge is we gotta get people that we detect with the spy plane or that we blinded with counter spy plane. Class setup, need an optic. Well, in my opinion, I do like the Microflex LED, simple, clear, to the point. For the muzzle, we do have the very first one you get, plus 4% vertical recoil control, muzzle brake 9. Next up is the barrel. We have the 9.5 extended. I like this for the added bullet velocity. And as a bonus, it's the first thing that you have unlocked. Then we move on down. Eventually, hopefully you can get to speed tape, plus 10% aim down sight time, ADS time. You know, we can speed that up, always a good thing. And then stock, the first stock is really good, plus 10% aim walking movement speed. So not a very hard setup to get a hold of. Tactical is stun, lethal, doesn't matter. For the field upgrade, if you can, use a jammer. Field might, the recharge time is 3 minutes, 30 seconds versus the jammer, which is 1 whole minute less, 2 minutes, 30 seconds. So that is why I say go for the jammer. But if you can't, then obviously the field mic is your only real choice. And then for our perk setup, we do have Paranoia, my personal favorite perk. Flak Jacket, perk 2 is Gearhead and Quartermaster. And finally, perk 3, which I believe is standard issue in free-for-all or many modes really, Ghost, and Cold-Blooded. And don't worry, we're going to get into the why. We got the streaks, the class, now for the playstyle. So, as the Flora challenge states, we need to kill someone while they are stunned, detected, or blind. So that, again, that is why the spy plane, counter spy plane is important. That's why we use those. Stun grenades. So if you can, before you pull the trigger on someone, you know, if they have their back towards you, they're kind of camping somewhere, they're just so clueless, you want to stun them. That will take some time to get used to. You know, you have that instinct to pull the trigger right away. Try and stun them. Once you do that, hey, you might as well go for that headshot. So this makes a lot of challenges easy, and this is why we run the quartermaster perk, recharge equipment over 25 seconds. So this gives us lots of chances to throw stuns. So depending on your choice, whether it was the field mic or the jammer, you need to be close enough to your field upgrade to get credit for a detected or a blinded kill. And it just so happens that this type of playstyle, it works perfect for free-for-all since you need to patrol a little area anyways versus running around the map, getting shot in the back. Like I said, I do always run Paranoia. It is my favorite. It lets me know if someone's flanking, lets you know if someone's aiming at you, trying to snipe you. And really, I guess your second perk one, that could be your choice. I did happen to run Flak Jacket, but really, whatever it is you like. We also have Gearhead, and that's basically so we get field upgrades a lot quicker. Perk 3, again, standard issue for free-for-all, Ghost and Cold-Blooded, hide from spy planes and streaks. And if you need to be quiet, all you gotta do is crouch walk. Very fast in this game, it makes you dead silent. And again, don't forget, we're also going for headshots at the same time, so always aim for the head if you can. And another thing, people like to run helicopters in free-for-all. If you see a helicopter, put two or three bullets, just a few of them, and then go about your day. What happens is, if someone eventually takes down that helicopter, you're gonna get credit, score credit, and that score goes towards your score streaks. Hey, you get an easy UAV or counter UAV. So for our challenges, spray, stripes, classic, flora, all those done at the same time in free-for-all. With those out of the way, from there we can now go back to geometric. Get 50 long shot medals with the MP5 and multiplayer. I already made a whole separate video just on this, but let's cover it again. So the mode is hardcore kill confirmed. I recommend this for a couple reasons. The long shots, you need to play super passive from a distance. Some people will call that camping. I like to call it patrolling from a distance. And so unlike another mode, like say domination, where you need to capture a flag, you gotta be kind of more aggressive. In kill confirmed, it's way more chill. There's no pressure to capture anything. And yeah, there's the tags, but those are for your teammates. You get the kill and they get to collect them and get free score, okay? So it's a win-win. And on the flip side, when an enemy sees his friend's tag, they're gonna be tempted to go there and collect it to the same spot. When he does, hey, free kill, or even the person who killed, they may go back to the same spot looking for revenge, and you're gonna be there waiting for him. And some people have said, why not hardcore TDM? It's just a little bit slower, and that floating little tag, that really does help bring out people to, again, like I said, they wanna get revenge, or they wanna just collect the tag for points. And finally, the hardcore variant, it's one or two bullets from any range, and hey, for long shots, that is what we need. One shot, one kill. So we got the mode, hardcore kill confirmed. Let's move on to the class setup. And even though every SMG has different attachments, slightly different playstyle, you can still make a similar build, a similar mindset, overall playstyle. And so feel free to mix and match whatever it is that helps you play better. And let's just skip right down to the bottom for Gunfighter. Gunfighter is gonna allow us to unlock three additional attachment slots for your primary weapon. Now, normally I don't like Gunfighter because I like to run a lot of perks, but since we're just gonna be stationary for the most part, we want every single bit of attachments. So the first up is the axial arm sight, a 3X on an SMG. It works so well. 3X is gonna just make it so much easier to find people. It's enough said. It's like a little miniature sniper. We used it on the ARs, very, very good. The muzzle is an infantry compensator for the plus 12% vertical recoil control. For the barrel, it's a 9.5 Ranger. This is actually very, very important. Plus 100% bullet velocity. What that does is eliminate bullet drop almost completely. Almost. Not completely. There is still a little bullet drop, but this is going to make it so you're kind of shooting a laser gun, or a hit scan is the tech term for it. All right, so this is kind of a big deal. Yes, we get negative 25% aim, walking movement speed, but we'll have something for to compensate for that later on. The SOF target designator is on the body, plus 60% reveal distance. On the underbarrel, it's a field agent grip, plus 6% on the vertical recoil control, and plus 20% on the horizontal. So that makes it very, very accurate. The downside is negative 30% shooting movement speed, but we're not going to be doing any running and gunning, so who cares? It doesn't matter to us. And for the magazine, I end up going with the 40 round drum, extra ammo, extra starting ammo, ammo capacity goes up. It's just win, win, win. And you don't really need reload quickness when you're sitting on the back of a map, right? The handle is a serpent wrap. Use this on the ARs, plus 25% ADS. So useful when you're using the 3X scope. And there you go. The downside, negative 10% spread out fire time. Again, doesn't matter to us because we're not running, we're not gunning. We are camping it out. So we got the stock next, SAS combat stock, plus 5% shooting movement speed. It's kind of nice. Plus 15% aim walking movement speed. Really good for ducking in and out of cover. And the downside, again, it doesn't really affect us. Negative 15% hip fire accuracy. When we're sniping, it's just not really an issue. Secondary, who cares? Tactical, truly anything you want. But in hardcore, someone may get a hit marker on you and your HUD is going to be completely bloody. Your hearing is going to be messed up. The stim shot will counter that. But again, any of these, I suppose, could work. C4. I like the C4 personally, but that is really your choice. It's not a big deal. I will explain it later on. Proxy mine has a very low cooldown, okay? We're going to need to watch our flank. This has a recharge time of 2 minutes. Sure, you can use a field mic, but look at that recharge time, 3 minutes and 30 seconds. So that kind of speaks for itself. So I like the proxy mine. Perk setup, the first one is Paranoia, love it. Second is Assassin, third is Cold-Blooded. I will explain these in just a minute. So as you've caught on from the gameplay, it's all about patrolling from range. And the C4 is really just for bait. You set it near your flanks, put it near a doorway, and you want to make it super duper easy to see out in the open. You don't want to hide it. You want the enemy to see it and you want them to shoot it. So that way you have some sort of warning that someone is nearby. If you're hiding in a room, you tend to get naded. So flak jacket doesn't really seem to do anything in hardcore, and that's why I don't recommend it. Tac mask is kind of useful. People do stun you, but it's just not as useful as paranoia. Someone is flanking you from your left or your right, and you're going to get that audio cue and the visual cue. And as I said, the field upgrade could be anything. Proxy mine does have that cooldown of 2 minutes versus the field mic of 330. The proxy mine, though, that you definitely want to hide, since that's going to get you a kill and you don't get those every single life, unlike the C4. The assassin perk is just pretty much there to get extra score, and that's going to lead to the streaks. The final perk is cold-blooded, so that way we don't have to worry about score streaks, helicopters, air support. We can just stay planted in our little camping spot and not have to worry about stuff shooting us. And with geometric out of the way, now we can work on science. Kill 75 enemies at point blank range and multiplayer. This too was also covered in a separate video, but let's go ahead and put that right here. First, we got to know what exactly is a point blank kill. Well, it's just like how they describe it. It is literally a kill with bullets that are point blank, that is in knife range. And that's the mentality you have to have going into this. If you're close enough to knife someone, that is a point blank. Another thing is the point blanks only count if it's with your bullets. So if you try using the butt of your gun to melee them, that is not going to count. It must be bullet damage only. So now that we know what a point blank is, let's get into the game mode. As usual, you could do this in any mode, but modes where there is an objective, those tend to work best. Modes with predictable spawns, those are even better. One is core control and the other is hardcore domination. So first up, control. Control is great because not only is there an objective to keep people distracted, but you know exactly where the enemy is spawning from in control. It is very hard set. They have one side, you guys have the other. And this makes it really easy to hide around a corner when you know exactly where the enemy is spawning from. So maybe control isn't your thing. Maybe the gun you're using is too weak. Don't like hit markers. Hardcore domination could work. But in hardcore domination, you need to lurk around the B flag or any high traffic area. Hardcore domination on Armada is amazing. And on that map, I was able to get at least 11 plus point blank kills in one game. Attachments and perks. So even though my example is the MP5, you can make a similar build with any SMG. So first up is the muzzle. So the muzzle, we have the sound suppressor. Very rarely do I use this. 100% muzzle flash concealment. It's going to keep us stealthy, keep us off the radar. The cons are negative 15% effective damage range, but we don't care about range because the whole point of this build is for point blanks, so doesn't matter. For the body, we have the SWAT 5MW laser sight plus 36% hip fire accuracy. The cons are we can't ADS, but again, this build is designed for up close, and if someone is right next to you, knifing range, you may not even have time to ADS, so that is why we have the high hipfire accuracy. Moving on to the magazine, I end up going with the very first one, the 40 round drum. We get more magazine ammo capacity, mag starting ammo, ammo capacity, that's all great. Point blank, that maybe you come across a situation with two or three or four people, you don't want to have to reload. And yeah, the negative is negative 10% reload, but who cares? We have the 40 rounds and we need this because you just have those weird situations where you need to get that double kill, and that's going to come in clutch. Moving on to the handle, have the first one, speed tape plus 10% ADS time. You know, why not? The stock, no stock, plus 30% sprint to fire time. Negative 15% hip fire accuracy, but we're going to counter that with the other attachment. We want a high sprint to fire time because we're going to be in close proximity of the enemy, and so that's why I have that build. But again, this is just suggestions. Basically, you want something that is made for close range. I like the setup a lot. It worked really good for me. Tactical, that is a smoke, and I'm going to go over all these in just a minute, why we have them. We have the Semtex, the jammer, which is just incredibly useful. For our perks, perk one, we have paranoia and tactical. Perk two is gearhead and quartermaster. Perk three is ghost and ninja. And all this is done because we have perk greed. So that's a class. Let's go over the playstyle. The smoke. I never run smoke, but it ended up working very, very good for this challenge. What it does is it causes a little bit of confusion, but more importantly, it's going to keep us from getting sniped and lets us get into their flanks, get into wherever it is that you want to lurk in that particular map. Places you want to lurk at, hang out, harass them, is that sweet spot just outside their spawn and just around the corner, so that way you catch them running towards whatever objective it is they're trying to get to. In the case of domination, I don't recommend running into their spawn because you just end up flipping it and then you have to run all the way across to the other side of the map. Instead, I would hang around the B flag, and that is where I would usually patrol Armada, the battleship map. It is so good for this. Multiple levels, lots of corners to creep around, and the jammer. The jammer can be placed in all sorts of hard to reach places. It's just way too good. It's just so good for this. Once you figure out where you want to harass them, where you want to hang out, the jammer is not only going to hide you, but it also disables any mines, C4, sentry guns, their HUD is all screwed up, all of that. Very, very good. And be creative where you place it. All right. Don't put it out in the open. For example, the jammer, if it's at ground level, it jams everyone that's at the top level. So if they want to destroy it, they have to go all the way, you know, down to sea level or wherever it is that you hit it. Or what you could do is just place it right outside the main room on Armada, outside of main traffic area. Semtex, I love the frag. The frag is probably my favorite. But Simtex is very, very good for close range, exactly where we're going to be hanging out, harassing them. The Simtex is used when you need to reload your gun, you need time to heal. You can just toss it at the ground, toss it where you think they'll be coming from. And if it doesn't kill them, they're going to take some damage. And that might just be enough where you can swap weapons, shoot them down with one bullet. It can help you out a lot. And a lot of pros use it in that way. So that's where I kind of got that from. All right, so the perks, the reason why I picked Paranoia is just so good. It could tell you when you're being flanked, someone from behind. Perk one, I suppose it really could be anything. You could use Flak Jacket. You can use Engineer, Tac Mask. Those are all very good. Engineer is kind of pointless, though, if you have a jammer, because it's going to destroy or disable all their stuff. So it's kind of a your choice type of thing. However, in perk two, I do like Gearhead because it reduces field upgrade cooldown. Store up to 2 field upgrade charges, and then the quartermaster recharge your equipment over 25 seconds. So you get all the stuff that we're using, you get it a lot quicker. And this build, close range, you're gonna be using your jammer, you're gonna use your smoke, you're gonna use your Simtex, you're using all these things. So why would you not wanna run quartermaster and gearhead to get them faster? And then for perk 3, Ghost, for obvious reasons, lets us flank in peace, keeps us off the radar. And then Ninja, when you're on a ship like Armada and you're stomping on metal, it's very, very, very loud. So Ninja will counter that. It allows you to, remember, you got to be point blank. So you want to be stealthy. So the Ghost and the Ninja combination, I feel like that is a must have. On many other challenges, I would run cold-blooded. But here, since the goal is to be sneaky, get into position, I just feel like Ninja and Ghost, they take priority over that. But again, in the end, just use whatever matches your playstyle. So other than lurking and being an overall nuisance, you gotta remember, just be within knife range. You know, just pretend you're holding a knife, but you have to pull the trigger. That's it. Think of it like that. And that is why for certain weapons, hardcore domination may be a better alternative than control, because people will run away from you and you'll end up getting a hit marker. Maybe you'll miss like 2 shots. So hardcore can kind of compensate for that, because if you're point blank or within a couple of meters of them, one shot, one kill. And then finally, there is an odd bug with this challenge. It's very rare and weird. Let's say that you're 2 or 3 kills away from completing the science challenge. You cannot complete this challenge if you joined a game in progress. It just won't count. I actually completed this challenge like 2 or 3 times, but it was always in a game in progress. Once you joined a fresh game, it will register. And then finally, we have Psychedelic. Kill 2 or more enemies rapidly 25 times in multiplayer. We need something aggressive, so that is what this is built around. We have no optic, we don't need it for headshots, those are already done. For our muzzle, we have Muzzle Break 9, plus 4% on the vertical recoil control. Moving down to barrel, the 9.5 extended, plus 40% bullet velocity. I like those fast bullets. We're gonna skip on down to a magazine. We have the very last one that you get, the Salvo 40 round fast mag. You get a nice bonus in the field ammo capacity. 40% reload quickness, 33% mag starting ammo, 33% ammo capacity. Yes, the ADS goes down, but we're gonna be very close to enemies, so it's really not gonna be that big of an issue. Plus, we have the speed tape handle for the plus 10% ADS time. And then finally for the stock, we have the SAS combat stock, plus 5% shooting movement speed and plus 15% aim walking movement speed. I know that that stock has negative 15% hip fire accuracy, but I'm not really firing from the hip. All right, tactical is stem shot, lethal is Simtex, field upgrade is jammer, but that could be whatever it is that you like, maybe proxy mine, anything that it is available to you. Perk setup, we are using Perk Greed, of course, to get 6 perks again. We do have Paranoia, Tac Mask, Perk 2 is Assassin and Quartermaster, Perk 3 is Ghost and Ninja. We have the class, now we need the mode. The mode is Control, the same mode that was great for point blanks. Perfect, great mode for double kills, stim shot. So when you're hovering around the enemy spawn, you're gonna take damage. We should already know this from the previous challenges. And even if you get a kill, there's always gonna be another enemy lurking by because it's their spawn, of course. So the stim shot allows you to heal almost instantly and get ready for your next confrontation. Simtex, already went over this, but it's great for buying time and getting kills in clutch moments. If you see someone rushing you through a door, you can just toss down that Simtex, and that gives you, you know, 1 or 2 seconds, get to reload your gun, hit your stim shot, get ready. So even though I love Paranoia, Flak and Tac Mask are both great, since players, they will know that you're close by, and they'll try throwing a stun at you, a grenade, maybe even both. So maybe you may want to run Flak and Tac and just forget about Paranoia. I'm just addicted to Paranoia. I love that perk. We do run the perk Assassin. It is pretty much just to earn spy planes. You know, you get a random kill on someone on a 2-kill streak and you get extra credit for that. We do have Quartermaster. That perk lets us get more stim shots faster. And finally, Ghost and Ninja let us run around the outskirts of the respawn undetected. And as you caught on, it's super duper aggressive playstyle. Hey, if you want to run inside enemy spawn, go ahead. There's no way you're going to flip it, but they will know where you're at more often than not. It really wasn't that hard, just time consuming due to the rank being held back by time played. So hopefully this is fixed in a future update. Please be sure to hit like on the video, guys. It really, really helps me out. And you can watch me play live on Twitch. Link to that down below, and check out these other cool videos.